Are you ready? It's time for another great infotaining show filled with power-packed business and life information. Welcome to Your Future Is Now with your host, Jim Grant, and co-host, Don McGrath. Want to know how to create a fantastic TED Talk? Or how you can become an author or a speaker or build your own online business? Maybe it's reaching a level of success in your life that you deserve. Their show is designed to provide information to assist you towards your success and destiny. Each week, Jim and Don will interview a special guest and share exciting lessons. So grab a pen and paper. Take some notes. Thanks for joining the show. Now, here's Jim.
Well, thank you, Lisa, for that wonderful introduction. She does all of our commercials and introduction for us. She does a wonderful job. I just want to give a shout out to Lisa Horlanda and thank her for the wonderful job she does there. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the show. Your Future Is Now is proudly sponsored by the good guys at speakerspathway.com. And at speakerspathway.com, we're very proud to be able to deliver to you some messages of inspiration and hope. We have interviewed over 200 speakers there, and we did this originally to help people during the during this pandemic. And most importantly, we did a call for speakers. And I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, the speakers came out of the woodwork. They delivered powerful messages of inspiration and hope. And all you got to do is go to speakerspathway.com. That's speakerspathway.com. And just scroll down, you'll see the Messages of Inspiration and Hope show. You will see three speakers there. Underneath there, you'll see more. And we have all of our individual speakers listed there. Each one has a wonderful message. Click on any of the messages you choose. Please let that speaker know that you really enjoyed their presentation. And also, our guest today is a beautiful lady by the name of Christine Patton. She's joined us from Canada. And she was also one of our guests on the Messages of Inspiration and Hope show. I'm joined today by the honorary host here at Toganet Radio, Mr. Bill Heinrich. And Mr. Bill Heinrich, he is the author of The Seven Levels of Truth. And I'd like to give you a free gift from Mr. Bill, if I may. He has Clarity Has No Story. You can get it. It's an ebook for free at myfreebook.me. M as in Mike, E as in Echo. That's myfreebook.me. M as in Mike, E as in Echo. And let me say to Mr. Bill Heinrich, welcome to the show, sir.
Good morning, Jim, or good afternoon, depending upon where everybody is. How are you? I'm really excited about our guest today.
Oh, absolutely. I tell you right now, she's a wonderful lady, Christine Patton. I was teasing before we opened up the show. I said she had to put up with me on the Messages of Inspiration and Hope show since I host it. And she's got a powerful, powerful message of the road to resilience. And Christine, we are so glad that you joined us. Welcome to the show.
Good morning, Jim. Good morning, Bill. It's a real pleasure to be here. Thank you for inviting me. I feel honored.
Well, I tell you right now, we're the ones that's honored because it takes great guests like you to make us look good. And ladies and gentlemen, I want to give a shout out to all you folks out there that have listened to our show, subscribed to our show. We are now downloaded in over 8 different podcasts, from big ones to small ones, started from Google Podcasts, iHeartRadio, all the way down to, we're on iTunes and Spotify, but we got some smaller ones too. We just got picked up and we're just so thankful. And I want to personally thank you for, listening to our show, subscribing to our show, and helping us share good messages of inspiration and hope. That's what we always do here at this show at Your Future Is Now. And Mr. Bill, I tell you, you have really been a tremendous asset to the show, being the honorary host. And I just want to say a real big shout out and thank you, sir.
Well, you're welcome. It's really great to be here. It's really a gift to be involved in something where we can make a difference in somebody's life, Jim, isn't it?
It really, really is, because that is the key in everything that we do. That's what Bill does. That's what Christine does. That's what, we do at Speakers Pathway Coalition. The 6-minute webinar. Oh, my goodness gracious. I've got to tell you a little bit about that. Bill, would you be so kind as to share with the folks what happened last Saturday?
Well, we've myself and Don McGrath are the co-creators of the six-minute webinar. And last Saturday, we put on our first boot camp with the six-minute webinar called Nail Your Niche, because that's what happens when you do a six-minute webinar. And in fact, I was just on the phone with somebody that was there. They had a couple of questions, and they were kind of headed in the wrong direction with what they were, the message they wanted to bring through their webinar. And when I showed him the correct way to go, he just went, "Oh my gosh, that's exactly it." You know, people value time over money, and they're just sick and tired of getting on these 1 and 2 hour webinars where they're bribed to stay to the end through some gift or something else. And the webinars themselves, in most cases, aren't successful because the people putting on the webinars are giving away too much information and education. Where people, the thing I heard a couple of weeks ago in a mastermind group I'm in is today people are looking for immediate answers. And I know that Christine is going to give them some immediate answers in dealing with resilience. And that's where the power is today. And that's what the six-minute webinar does, is it really focuses in on one specific powerful message so that it resonates with the right person, Jim.
It really does. And the wonderful thing, too, ladies and gentlemen, make a note of it. October the 24th, we're going to do it again. And we had 44 people in that three-hour webinar with no bio breaks, and no one left. And in fact, when Don was wrapping up the show, people were saying, "Hey, wait a minute, we want some more. This stuff's too good." And that's when you know that you're really singing their song. And today, Christine Patton, she's going to be singing a lot of people's song when she starts talking about the road to resilience. So, Christine, would you kindly just introduce us about what you talk about, resilience, and what it means to you and your message?
Oh, absolutely. And please feel free to call me Chris. I use Christine as a professional name, but my friends call me Chris, and you're welcome to do that. I think there's agreement among everybody that resilience is a real buzzword these days. It captures all the ways that we can keep ourselves strong moving forward and have a sense of wholeness about us as we look at our lives. We all want to feel good about our lives. And it's just been kind of difficult lately, you know, with something small like a worldwide pandemic, you know, whatever. We want to feel resilient in the face of our responsibilities, but we just feel short. Many of us, I can't blanket the world with that. But I think what happens is from the work that I've done, the speaking that I've done, the coaching that I've done, there's a real ignorance about what stress really is. So today we're going to zero in on what stress really is so that we know what to do about it. So it's important to understand it's a physiological state in the body. So that's what we're going to talk about today.
Wow, that's really something. That's something that a lot of people need to learn how to deal with stress and recognize it. And Bill, I know that you help a lot of people with clarity in their minds. And when you're dealing with someone that's dealing with stress, what are some of the things that you share with them?
Well, the thing that I really keyed in on is what Chris just said when she talked about people trying to deal with the pandemic. And as I think the words you used, Chris, were they're coming up short. And the reason for that is because our lives are so out of control now. Wouldn't you agree with that, Chris? Like there's no safety. It's been taken away from us. Would you agree with that?
There's definitely that feeling. And when we're faced with something that we have had no control over, it's the control piece that drives people insane. So yes, absolutely, I agree.
And that's, you know, that absence of safety would be where stress comes from. And what are some of the things they should do, or how can they handle it, Chris?
First thing is to understand what it is. It's not some nefarious psychological program that we don't understand, so we don't take any steps to conquer it. We have to understand it's a state in the body that we keep ourselves in. So before we go to commercial break, I'm going to land this on you. And that is, it's a triple axis. It's between your brain, your autonomic nervous system, and your heart. This is really the simplest way to describe it. And one feeds into the other and continues to keep us in a fight or flight state in our bodies. So we have to understand that we are creating it. And more importantly, when it is a physiological condition, we also know that there's something that we can do about it physically. We have to meet it in a physical way. So that should pique a little bit of interest, I think.
Well, it immediately got my attention. What's one of the physical ways that people can address it, Chris?
It's to modulate heart rhythms. So I am a certified practitioner and trainer with the HeartMath Institute of California. And the whole system is designed to take control by focus on the heart. And so when you can ground that physiological change into your body, now it's lasting. Now you've conquered it. This is not a moment by moment feeling better. This isn't self-care. This isn't a light form of meditation. This is actually fixing the stress in the body by modulating or changing your heart rhythms, not your heart rate. So there are ways to do that.
That's really amazing. You know, Chris, we're getting ready to go to break here. But would you very quickly share with people your website and how someone can get in touch with you? Because this is going to be a tremendous show.
Absolutely. Thank you. My website is powerwithin.ca. There's a contact page. You can email me with any questions. Have a look and see about the work that I do. This is one of the main underpinnings of all my speaking, all my coaching is the HeartMath work, just because it's so important today. Chris at Power Within, you can reach me there or at 250-864-7299, and you will be calling Canada.
Thank you so much. And ladies and gentlemen, all of these websites and phone numbers will be in the description of the show. And I don't know about you, but I'm going to ask her to talk a little bit more about that heart math. I want to hear a little bit more about that when we come back later on in the show. So please stay with us. We'll be right back right after these messages.
Sponsor of Your Future Is Now, a show dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the vision and mission of Speaker Pathway. Dr. Sony Jackson's expertise is on the art of marketing while cultivating a long-term customer relationship in your business world. Do you know what to say or how to deliver your message to complete strangers? If so, Sony can help you. Tamara Hunter is a cancer survivor and works with people to focus their message or mission to the audience they want to reach. Do you feel called to create a movement to make the world a better place? If so, Tamara can help you. For additional information from any of our executive training directors, go to speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
You have a lot of spizzeratum or the will to win, and you have a strong desire to be a part of your favorite sports team, the National Hockey League might be for you. Did you know that if both goalies on an NHL hockey team are injured, anyone at the game is eligible to step in and play the part? Teams have resorted to using their coaches, team owners, and even their web designers to fill in for injured goalies. It's as simple as slipping into your breezers or hockey pants. The original hockey puck was made out of frozen cow dung. The fastest puck shot on record was clocked at 114 miles per hour. And I'd like to take this opportunity to send out a special thanks to the men and women of our armed forces serving our country around the world. I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
Well, Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future Is Now is proudly sponsored by the good guys at speakerspathway.com. It's also the home of the six-minute webinar. And I tell people all the time that the six-minute webinar is just a very simple program that you put together that has one crystal clear message. We want to speak to one client and solve their problem. And Mr. Bill, I know you can explain it better than I can. Would you be kind enough to give a good description of the six-minute webinar, sir?
Well, I'd be happy to. The easiest way to describe it is we all do many different things. We have Chris on today talking about how to deal with stress. And stress comes from many different areas. So in the case of Chris, it would be a message to the perfect client that she can help the most. Just to one person, one message, very specific. And with that being said, I know we were talking about the autonomic nervous system, and we spoke a little, it's easy for me to say, and we also spoke a little bit, Chris, about fight or flight. So yeah. Let's get into that message right there. These are sure. Great topics.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. So understanding the physicality of this, which the reason I feel it's really important to understand it is because now we know how we can take control. So our brain is wired to keep us out of danger. So for example, we came out of our cave, 500,000 years ago, a million years ago, and we saw a saber-toothed tiger. So if we didn't want to be lunch, it was either fight or flight. So the body's capability to mobilize immediately is what kept us alive. I mean, this is the biological imperative. We have to stay alive. So what happens is the brain signals the autonomic nervous system to put us into this mobilization state. And so our blood pressure goes up, the heart rate goes up, all the resources go to our limbs, bunch of other things happen. And what happens is also the autonomic nervous system, any change in that affects the heart on a beat-to-beat basis. So now your heart is in a dysregulated rhythm because we're in fear and we're ready to meet the danger. Now, we have more nerves going from the heart to the brain than the other way around. So it's an afferent nerve system. And the heart continues to inform the brain that we are dysregulated and we are in fight or flight. And this is the communication path that takes place. And this is a great system. I mean, there's now 8 billion people on the planet. So, I mean, it showed that it works. It's kept us out of danger. We add to that, as we talked about on the break, it's not just the saber-toothed tiger at the head of the cave. We're talking about perceived stress. So these are the worries about the future. These are the regrets about the past. None of that is in the present. And I call that perceived stress because they're not in our immediate vicinity to deal with. So added on to all of our perceived stress, now we add COVID, we add all the other problems in the world that are proving to be truly problematic to many people. And now we've got systems that have gone haywire. This is what has happened in the body. So this is what we need to take control of. There's something else too, called subconscious programming. Mm-hmm. This is the programming in our cells that we grew up with in terms of what we choose to worry about. What we choose is important to us, what we don't like, what makes us angry, what makes us sad. And it's this automatic programming that runs 95% of our life that we're not even conscious of. So really important to understand that there are many unconscious programs we live by that are causing a lot of our own stress. And until we understand what those programs are, we don't know how to change them. So I want to add that there's something there that keeps us in fight or flight as well, that, again, we are in control of and are responsible for. And if it's something we've learned, we can unlearn it and do something different.
So you spoke about the nerve endings. There's more from the heart to the brain than the brain to the heart. So this is how you're able to make this transition. Is that correct?
Exactly. When you can start to modulate your heart rhythms, now you've got a different signal going to the brain. And the signals go to your executive functions, your thalamus, we have over-enlarged amygdalas. That's the fear center. That's what's kept us alive. But with everything going on in the world, we've got a fear center that overreacts to everything. The hippocampus, the hypothalamus, there's parts of the brain that are designed to, again, keep us alive and to keep us functioning well. And those are the centers, particularly the executive functions in the thalamus that the heart speaks to.
So what you're saying is to, in taking control, is recognizing that you're in that fight or flight mode or that there's some sort of stress.
That is
so part. Right. What's one step that people can do?
Well, there are 8 techniques that the HeartMath, well, there's probably more now, but very basically, breath and mindfulness. Now, where do they come from? We've been doing yoga for centuries. So breath and mindfulness, breath on its own is our tool to bring our heart rate down, to calm our nervous system. And we know this. When a child is having a tantrum, or somebody's having a hard time, what do we say to them? We say, just breathe, just breathe. And that's the physiological trigger to bring everything back to normal. So breath on its own, and we know this too, breath catalyzes a lot of things in our body, but just that alone will help. The focus on the heart, which is what the HeartMath Institute, obviously by its name, focuses on. Amazing things happen when we focus on the heart and the power of the heart to govern not only our bodies, but our lives. And so, sorry, go ahead.
Well, I was going to ask, how does someone focus on their heart?
Just think about your heart in the center of your chest.
It's as simple as that.
Wow.
It is. So this is a combination program. It is really very simple and not time consuming at all. This is about breathing in through your nose. HeartMath recommends 5 seconds in and 5 seconds out. And the whole time focusing on the heart. Now, eventually when you establish a comfortable rhythm and you're more relaxed, when you begin to think about breathing in and out through your heart, now you've really integrated breath and the heart. And this is the beginning, the first step called heart-focused breathing that anybody can do. And you can do it on the run. You can do it sitting in a meeting. I wouldn't do it driving a car, but...
That's really interesting because, Chris, I'm sitting here and I'm listening to you and going, my goodness, I hope there's probably are some people out there like me and say, tell me more, because, Bill, I'll tell you right now, she's talking about some things I never even thought of. How about you, brother?
Yeah, well, I do have some experience in this area, but I love this process. I know the HeartMath Institute has been around for a long time. And to have it broken down in this way so that people have something, especially in these times where people are finally admitting that their lives are out of control, as they have been during the pandemic. Right, Chris?
Yeah, that's a big piece is finally admitting that things are not great so that you can take that first step. When we're in denial, we just kind of mess around for a long time. And in any steps we take sometimes are not focused, are not for our highest good. And here's the thing, when we can quiet our nervous system, we can hear our intuition. We can hear ourselves think. We can hear ourselves, feel ourselves feel. So really important to start the process. Just start somewhere, you know?
Someone listening out there, Chris, they might say, wow, tell me more. I mean, I'm going to ask you once again, if you'd be so kind, as to how they can find you on the internet. If you give them your website and email address, please.
Absolutely. Powerwithin.ca is my website. And you can reach me at Chris, CHRIS, @powerwithin.ca. Thank you.
I like that website. It's very descriptive of what you're talking about here. All the power is within. And I'm just making notes here about the 5 second, you know, breathe in for 5 seconds and out for 5 seconds and how it really calms you down. And it's, you know, I've heard this before, but I'm hearing it brand new and fresh from a different light today. I can say that. And Bill, I know that you're more of an expert in this than I certainly am. And I tell you, it's really opening my eyes. Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, the thing that comes to mind is as a child, when I would, how would I describe it? When I was going nuts,
you know, yeah.
My mother would say, just take a deep breath.
Yes.
Stop and take a breath. Like those words were echoing in my ears when you said that, Chris. It's which is exactly what you're talking about here. So as you feel this coming on, it's pausing. Is the step, right? Pause and breathe.
Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, just take the pause. You know, we do come equipped with far more than we give ourselves credit for. We are here to meet every demand. We're here to meet every problem. We have the tools. We just forget. We just forget. And then we don't develop anything that helps us. Well, not anything, but we don't develop the things that help us the best.
Yeah, I know they say God will never give you more than you can handle.
Yes.
But there's days where I feel like he has too much confidence in me.
You have to have a conversation with that God. It's true.
Oh, my goodness. That's so true. I tell you, it's really amazing because looking here at your notes, and I'm taking it all about the subconscious programming, a lot of people get caught up into that, and that just short wires everything out, and they just lose focus. And we want to talk some more about what she's discussing here, Chris. And I tell you right now, it's just been very enlightening for me. And I know there's a lot of people out there. I say, hey, Jim, I know what you're saying. I can relate to you because you know, a lot of this stuff we know, but we don't know because we don't practice it. And we're going to stop for commercial break, but we'll be right back right after these messages.
This show, Your Future Is Now, is sponsored by SpeakersPathway.com. And just like the show, we are dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the same vision and mission of helping people to find their future. Is fear holding you back from your calling or your life mission? Do you struggle with taking that first step? If so, Bill Henrich is our catalyst to help you create perspectives with new possibilities that will bring you more peace, more joy, more love in your life and freedom. Do you struggle trying to build your strategy? Do you know how to reach your end results? If not, Gigi Ames is your expert in strategy and helping you create your step-by-step game plan to reach your finish line. For more information on creating the life you want to live, reach out to Bill Henrich. Or if Gigi Ames can help you with building your strategy with your end goal in sight, go to speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
It's words you never heard.
English isn't always the most expressive language in the world. Many other languages have words that are much more descriptive in their meaning. University of East London psychologist Tim Lomas compiled words from other countries that don't translate or have an English equivalent. Peiskos is a Norwegian word that means sitting in front of a crackling fireplace enjoying the warmth. Gula is Spanish for the desire to eat simply for the taste. And shamomachamo is a Georgian word that means eating past the point of satiation due to sheer enjoyment. Feierabend is a German word for the festive mood at the end of a working day. To quote Mark Twain, the difference between the right word and the nearly right word is the difference between lightning and lightning bug.
It's merging
never. I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. We're visiting today with Chris Patton. And I can tell you right now, I feel a little bit like Star Trek, because you've gone some places before no one's ever gone before in my mind. And I hope you're enjoying the show, because Chris is really revealing some things to us that a lot of times we realize and we know it, but we don't, or we're not able to reach it or practice it because of all of the other nonsense going on sometimes in our minds. And we need to clear that out. But Your Future Is Now is proudly sponsored by the good guys at speakerspathway.com and the 6-minute webinar. And I'm also joined today by the honorary host here on TogiNet Radio, Mr. Bill Heinrich. Mr. Bill, this has just been a fantastic show so far, hasn't it, sir?
It really has been. And it's all too familiar to me, Jim. Not the solution part of it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. I understand.
But the stress part of it. You know, there was a point in my life where I really just started to refer to it as hallucinations, you know, because there was no solution for an imagined problem. And there's something to do with our subconscious and old beliefs. And I'd like Chris to talk about that a little bit.
Oh, I'd love to. This is really interesting for many people. Not too many people understand this, but we are programmed in utero. So when we are forming to become a fetus and a baby in our mother's bodies, we are absorbing her predominant cascades of emotion. So depending on our mother's mental and emotional health and how she handled things, we are at the mercy of that. Also, the chief stress hormone called cortisol crosses the placental barrier. Now, health professionals know that in extreme cases, it can cause what's called brain sculpting, and that is it can actually damage the hardwiring of the brain. So that's where it starts. And then it just continues. It's like the fun game just continues on. When we are babies, we sleep a lot. And as we know, when we're in sleep, we are in a brain state called delta. So it's a very slow wave. The baby is taking in everything in his or her environment. So downloading all kinds of ideas about life. Then between the ages of 2 to 6, it increases to the theta brain state. Now it's a little faster, but still very slow. This is the suggestive hypnotic brain state without the critical ability to discern whether something is actually true. So taking in messages inadvertently, even in our small childhood, is what forms our ideas about ourselves, about life, what's important, what's good, what's bad, what's right, what's wrong. We think all these things are just the way it is, but we've learned them. We've learned them from our chief caregivers, our parents, whoever, babysitters. This goes on to age 6 or 7. And we've heard this, that our subconscious is fully formed by the time we're 6, 7, or 8 years old. The literature is all over that. So very, very critical to be planting better ideas into our children's psyches, especially about self-worth, you know, self-worth, deservingness, things like that, what we feel we can have in life. So that's what I wanted to talk about. These things are really deeply held and not identified in too many cases. So when we can shine a light on that, people have a better opportunity to say, sometimes it's just revolutionary. My clients, I can see the light go on behind their eyes that, oh my goodness, that's why I keep attracting this pattern in life, because I have this belief about myself that's X, Y, and Z. Now you can change it.
Yeah, you said something just a little while ago about whether it's true or not. So what I'm surmising from this is it really doesn't matter if it's true. It's how you're reacting to it. Is that correct?
Well, your truth is personal. You know, truth is a funny word. Truth, I think if I take it down to semantics, truth is what many people believe. No, I forget how that analogy goes. I'm not going to start that. But truth is very personal. And just because other people believe something does not necessarily mean that it is that way for you. So mm-hmm. everybody's mm-hmm. inner truth is different. Now, if you're not solid in your self-image or your self-esteem or your own opinions, you will fall for everything around you, all of the ideas about what is true and what you should be doing and who you should be in society. So really important to delve deeply into what we really believe will be for our highest good.
Mm-hmm. I'd like for you to also, you know, I love it when you mentioned about the the self-worth, because I think that's one of the big things that people struggle with. They don't feel like they're worthy. Or, you know, subconsciously, and it kind of like drags them down. It robs them of their energy. It's like leaving your flashlight on after you go to sleep and you wake up and the batteries are dead. You know, it's just, it's a horrible mindset for someone to think that they're not worthy. And how do you address that? What recommendations would you make for them on that?
Mm-hmm. Well, I think we all have programs to some degree about that. About what we hold dear, how we feel about ourselves. So there's work for everybody to do. Some people have more difficulties, of course, given their circumstances in life. To me, it's education. As a coach, it's helping my clients come to these realizations. Because, you know, people say they get stuck in these patterns. Crappy things are happening, and they're like, "Why me? Why me?" Because it is you. You have to understand. It is you. It's these patterns that are unconscious. We're not aware of how we think, which forms our attitudes, which forms what we say and what we do. And of course, we know that the energy that we tune ourselves to and the way that we act calls things to us. We attract at that level. So really important to understand, I've got this programming. I downloaded it from my mom or both my parents or my grandmother or a teacher or a coach or clergy or whoever. Now I can understand that I can change the thinking around that because I've now identified the problem.
Hmm.
Yeah, you know, Go ahead, Jim.
Please.
Well, I was going to say one of the basic laws of living that I have learned and an easy way to explain it is that water seeks its own level. So,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So speak a little bit more about that as it relates to who you attract into your life and what you attract.
Well, everywhere you go, there you are. You know, people complain about rotten marriages, rotten jobs, rotten friendships. And so they leave the situation and try another one. And pretty soon it's the same pattern happening. It's because that's what we're calling to us. These are the lessons that we've come here to learn, typically. So this is part of the richness and the deepness of doing this work, this heart math work, becoming more resilient. Because as we increase our health and our happiness in our body, we are raising our vibration. And HeartMath tells us that practicing the technique, which I will get into shortly, 5 to 15 minutes a day, 3 to 4 days a week, you will change your heart rhythms. And when you change your heart rhythms, your body's in a different state. Your cells now can work optimally. You have over 50 trillion cells in your body, 200 systems. And when we're in stress, those cells can't do their job. They simply can't do their job. So when we allow the cells to work, we're now healthy. And we know that when in our bodies, when we don't feel good, it affects our mood. We feel off. Mm-hmm. So as we raise our vibration, as we raise our energy levels and we feel better, we attract at that same level. That's the idea. That makes sense?
It makes perfect sense because I think we've all experienced that in our lives when things are going good and we're happy and we've got that vibrant glow and flow with us. I mean, it just seems to attract everything that you want in life. It's just all the nonsense things just seem to fall by the wayside.
That is exactly right. Yes.
In fact, yeah. The other day I was talking to someone and me and him got into a good conversation. And I mean, just the energy was just flowing and it was just like sparks flying off a wheel. And I hadn't talked to him in about, two or three years, but it was just really a wonderful conversation with him. And he had been through a lot of struggles in his life and how he had come back from health issues and things of this nature and how he overcame it. And he says, my biggest challenge was in between my ears. And I told him, I said, well, brother, you're singing my song there, because everybody will tell you that's my biggest challenge in between my ears.
That's everybody's challenge, Jim. It's not just yours. It's sometimes the biggest battle that we have, because we don't, first of all, we don't know what's there. And second, we don't want to admit that that's the problem.
Yeah,
but this is how we deplete ourselves, is staying in those states. And again, the simplest way is to take on a practice and create a new container in your life, that new container being a habit to sit quietly. Now, for some of my clients, sitting for 5 minutes a day is like asking them to, I don't know, climb a mountain. Just sitting still is a really big thing for a lot of people to do. And you know that when we sit there, we're thinking, well, I should be doing this. You're looking at your watch, planning your day, the next steps. We all do that. I still do it.
Yeah. You know, when I own the business and I went out to play golf, sometimes I would actually feel guilty because I'm out there playing golf. I should be out there enjoying myself and breathing the fresh air and sunlight and all that. But deep down inside, I felt guilty because I wasn't there at my office working. And that's the way you enslave yourself, isn't it?
Yeah, and it takes away from the ultimate enjoyment of the golf. So you're really defeating the whole purpose.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's understanding that everything in our life is fueled by us and who we are. And unless we feel that and invest in ourselves, we're not making good business decisions at all.
You are so correct there, and I couldn't agree with you more. And I share that with people so that if you're out there and you've been in the same ditch that I've been in, I mean, get out of it. Because once you start enjoying life, guess what? Everything else that you want to do, your task, you know, have a good attitude towards it and just be thankful for the things you get done during the day and don't fret about the things you can't get done because there's just not enough time on the clock there. And we're getting ready to go to another commercial break. We'll come back right after these messages. And again, we're going to have some more good information from Chris Patton. Thank you.
Your Future Is Now is sponsored by SpeakersPathway.com, and just like the show, we are dedicated and aligned in perfect harmony with the same vision and mission of helping people define their future. You may have heard that a picture is worth 1,000 words. Well, a video is worth 1,000 pictures. Koji Simaldi says, if you're not using video in 2019, you're going to get left behind. Most people feel lost or confused when it comes to marketing. Preston Martelli is a marketing guru whose strategies are both art and science in growing your business. Preston helps you make the right decisions that are predictable, measurable, and scalable. For additional information about Koji, Preston, or any of our executive training directors, go to our website at speakerspathway.com. That is speakerspathway.com.
Matters of the heart have baffled humans since the dawn of time. You just can't live or love without it. Weighing in at about 10 ounces, this blood-filled muscle has become the universal symbol for love. Over the course of one day, your heart will beat over 100,000 times, shuttling 2,000 gallons of blood through 60,000 miles of blood vessels in your body. Believe it or not, your mood can affect your heart health. One good cacination a day relaxes the lining in the blood vessel walls and increases good blood flow. Cacination is a laugh attack. But too much laughter might be a bad thing for some people. There have been enough documented cases of laughter inducing a coma that there is a medical term for it. It's called Lachschlackenfall.
It's words you never heard.
I'm Carolyn Davidson, and you can have fun challenging your words you never heard vocabulary with my free app, Too Funny for Word.
Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Your Future is Now is proudly sponsored by the good guys at speakerspathway.com. It is the home of the Messages of Inspiration and Hope show. If you go there, you can see a lot of different speakers that shared their message of inspiration and hope with everyone during these pandemic times. And our guest today, Chris Patton, she was one of our guests there on that wonderful show. And because she was there and many other great speakers, that show has really taken off and grown on its own legs. You can catch us at speakerspathway.com, and all of the guests there are listed there, and you can see their individual presentations. And I'm also joined by the honorary host here on Toganet Radio, Mr. Bill Heinrich. And Bill is the author of The 7 Levels of Truth. It's a wonderful book. And you can find it at TrueLifePurposeNow.com. That's TrueLifePurposeNow.com. That's Bill's website. And when he gave me his book, the first question he asked me, Chris, he says, Jim, I don't have too many pictures in there. Are you sure you can read? Bill knows me good. How you doing, Bill?
I'm doing good. Actually, he wasn't sure about the answer there, Chris, so I told him, just put it under your pillow when you go to sleep at night. You'll just you'll absorb it that way. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh my God.
So you were telling us a little bit on the break about how you got into this, Chris, and what was the reason, or I want to get to the feel-good moments here. Like what was it? What flipped the switch for you? And let's talk a bit about the feel-good moments from that.
Yeah, sure. Thank you, Bill. I had a great need. You know, you've both talked about how, you know, you're in stress and you've got that programming. Well, we all do. And I practiced law in Ontario for 15 years. I was an insurance defense litigator for 8. So I had a full-time practice, and I had 2 small children at home. And there were some days I honestly thought I was in such stress, I thought I was going to die. And I thought, well, I'm no good to anybody in that state. So I had to retire. I felt I had no choice, but I also felt like a huge failure. Why could other people do this and not me? So I embarked somewhat unconsciously, but somewhat consciously on a track to healing myself. And it began at the physical level, and it eventually became more spiritual. And along the way, I gathered these tools that I now coach with and teach with and talk about. And I have to tell you without reservation that one of the most critical steps I took was to learn the HeartMath system and to become coach and a trainer with them. I think the world of that company and the people who are part of it, they're truly loving, and they're teaching the world really excellent skills. And absolutely apropos today with stress. So I had to learn how to create my own richness in life, my own love of my life. And it's taken me a long time, 20, 25 years to get to this spot. And I have to tell you, I love every day of my life. And I have been practicing HeartMath for 5 years. It started with buying an M-Wave 2, which is their, it's like a mini biofeedback device, and learning how to alter my heart rhythms. And as my body has healed, I have felt better. I've taken on other practices as well. It's hard to say what works. You know, we do so many things, all of us, that it's the cumulative effect. But it's brought me to this place where I wake up in the morning happy and light. And I'm not kidding about that. I'm grateful all day long. I now live in the beautiful province of British Columbia in Canada, and I swear I live in God's country. It is heart-stopping. So many days I look at the mountains, the lake, I see my life, and I'm so grateful. And it's really the inner soundtrack of my life that I managed to change. As we know, as within, so without. It's that inner soundtrack that we're heading for here.
You know, as you're talking and describing everything, Chris, the thing that comes to my mind is that you sound like you just got the foundation there for the vibration of good health. because that's what everyone loves. And that's what I'm getting from this. I mean, it's just.
Oh, good.
I mean, tell I'm going to have the attitude right now. Just tell me more.
Wonderful. Sure. So here's the critical piece of the HeartMath system. And that is we talked about breath and mindfulness. Mm-hmm. The critical piece is to what I call conjure. So to bring in your body, renewing emotion. There, all emotions are good. When we were trained, we were taught not to say emotions were good or bad, positive or negative, but there are depleting emotions and there are renewing emotions. And so the idea is to create more of the renewing emotion, to be more present in our lives. So it's really helpful before we sit down to do the heart focused breathing, before we get into the 5 or 15 minute practice, is to create kind of a repertoire or a list of things in our lives that we're grateful for, that make us feel good, that we can really attach to in the moment to bring in that feeling in our body again. This is really important to do so that when you're practicing the technique, it is there, it is present. So it is this renewing emotion. This is what is going to create the state of what's called heart coherence in the body. Now, we have to understand, I hope I can continue. This Please. Is really important to understand. So this is not about your heart rate, because your heart beats at a certain rate, high or low. This is about the fact that your heart actually speeds up and slows down over time. It's not a regular heartbeat rate. And it's the pattern of your heart speeding up and slowing down that is indicative of being in heart coherence or incoherent. And as we're in stress, we are in a very dysregulated, incoherent pattern. It's a very jagged up and down look if you view the performance of your heart rhythms. What we're going for is the sine wave. You know, the gentle up and the curve at the top and the gentle down. And the bigger the amplitude in that wave means that you are more heart coherent. It is this state that is creating this beautiful feeling in your body and is helping your cells to operate optimally.
That's really interesting because, Bill, as she's sitting there describing, I'm thinking, wow, that's something I've never really heard before. I know you're familiar a little bit with the HeartMath Institute and all that, but if a lot of people out there may be like me and say, wow, I mean, I've just never really, you know, heard it explained like that before. And how about you, Bill?
Oh, I agree. I actually was drifting off a little bit as you were talking about the coherence and incoherence. It's mm-hmm. really... a wonderful way to state it, Chris. It really makes a difference.
Well, thank you. So this is what the HeartMath stands for, is let's create more heart coherence. Now, a bunch of things happen. The more coherence we can create within our body. Number one, we feel awesome because now your heart is in alignment with your brain, alignment mm-hmm. with your body. There is alignment in the system and alignment with your emotions. So now everything is quiet and powerful. This is not a sleepy, relaxed state. This is a quiet but powerful, ready-to-go state. Number two, as I indicated originally, you have 50 trillion cells in your body, 200 systems. Now they can work optimally. So you are healthier as time goes by and you create more coherence in your body. Three, the more that you practice, the higher your baseline. So in other words, what we're doing is we're creating a higher default set point of where we fall. And this is a state we can create continually in our body with practice. This is not just when you're practicing. This is the state that your body is in, the natural default set point. I can't emphasize that enough. Lastly, here's the piece that I want to emphasize. The heart wave is a very strong carrier wave. We all have a heart field around us at least 3 to 5 feet. I understand bigger as we become more coherent. Now, the heart wave carries the information of who we are into your heart field. What happens in a high coherent state is other hearts sync up with yours. Other people feel great in your presence and they don't know why. Now, if that isn't love, I don't know what is.
So it actually extends out.
Yes.
Wow.
We have a heart field. So we feel people before we know them. Now, when we think about the ramifications of this, the energetic relational part of it is, think of what you can accomplish in your office, in your family, going to the grocery store and being with that, the checkout clerk, the teller at the bank, whatever. People look at you and they feel differently about you. If that's not being a model of love and a teacher of love, which is what we're here to do, we're here to learn, we're here to learn about love, I don't know what is.
Mm-hmm. Chris, I tell you right now, I mean, because there's going to be a lot of people listening to the show, and they're going to say, I've got to get in touch with this lady. I mean, once again, please be kind enough before we close the show to give your website and your email address to the folks out there.
Thank you, Jim. Yes, my website is powerwithin.ca. There's a contact page. You can email me and ask any questions. I am at chris@powerwithin.ca, C-H-R-I-S. I'm happy to answer any questions that you have. I am an inspirational speaker. I am a performance coach. And I'm an author. I wrote a book called Showing Up, Becoming the Me I Want to Be. It's available on Amazon. Aligning your life and work for true success. It encompasses a lot of this, of these empowerment tools and resilience tools that I speak about. Thanks for asking.
Oh, good. Thank you for sharing, because that's what we do here at Your Futures Now. It's all about sharing information with people. And also, I want to mention again, Mr. Bill's ebook, Clarity Has No Story. You can get your free copy at myfreebook.me. M is in Mike, E is in Echo. That's myfreebook.me. And Mr. Bill, you're also the author of The Seven Levels of Truth, aren't you, sir?
Yeah, I am. That's really true. You know, as I'm sitting here, I was wondering, Chris, what parting words, what's the final message that you want to leave with the audience?
Start today. Where will you be in a year?
Wow.
Well.
Where could you be? Where do you want to be, and how fast do you want to get there? Start today.
I saw a sign somewhere one time. It said the best time to have gotten this started was yesterday. The second best is right now.
Exactly. Empower yourself. Do yourself a favor. Love yourself. It's the only thing that's important.
Oh yeah. I tell you right now, ladies and gentlemen, this has been a wonderful show, and I want to thank everyone for tuning in and for subscribing to the show, and please share Chris's show, because this is her show. We just facilitate over it with others who could really benefit from her message. I'm Jim Grant on behalf of Mr. Bill Heinrich and Chris Patton. We want to thank you for tuning in today. We'll see you next week.
Thank you.